Zimbabwe, Congo, Burundi, Rwanda, Nigeria, and the people from China, a lot of countries stay in Hillbrow. Yeah, Hillbrow is for foreigners.
People that are meant to live together, once they understand that all of them are from outside, they are foreigners, so they have to stick together, to be together.
Wow, it's not an easy place to live. It's a very hard place, and the problem is that we are different culture, different traditions, different people, you understand? And there's a different life. Everyone lives his own life, their own life. Yeah.
People just trying to actually live a life here. They're all trying to make it. Everyone's trying to make it because we're also from different parts of Africa. And we're all here. You know, it's so diverse. So everybody's just trying to I think everybody wants a bit of the pie. I call it a pie or a cake. In the old days, they said, like Joburg was like, gold, you came here for gold, you know, diamonds, it was that sort of thing.
From 98, by the time when I came here, South Africa, it was very nice. It was very nice, and it was a good country by that time. It was saving money, even if I was working for 30 rand, but it was working that 30 rand. But now I saw that too much people, I'm sure, too much people from the other sides, many countries, not Zimbabwe only, many countries, they were here. They were meeting here in Joburg, all Joburg, even in Sandton, whatever. They were there, all those people, they were staying there. So everywhere, South Africa has got many...
There's a lot of foreigners.
Many, too much foreigners here.
So the people that have always lived before and now, in Hillbrow, keep their cultures, you know. You'll find, like, for example, there's more Mozambicans going to that particular bar and drinking, so that almost becomes like a Mozambican bar. Or more Nigerians are going to a specific place and that becomes more of a Nigerian hangout. So that's what I like about the place, that there is this great diversity of people and all getting along with each other, you know, respecting each other and learning from each other, which I think is most important. And having respect for the place, you know. There's a community feel, which you don't always get in every place that you live. But here there is. There's a great sense of community. And I think that actually stems from our local black South Africans and sort of filters out amongst everybody else.
These people, they are combined together, and but they don't show anger to each other. No, they just work together like brothers and sisters. You see, you got Congolese, you got Senegal, you got Burundi, you got Zambians, you got Tswanas. You see, it's like all African meet together, but they work together.
No, we are treating each other like nobody cares about anyone here. It's Hillbrow, that's all. The people that care about you, it's your friends and the people you are close to. Otherwise, it's not a right community otherwise.
Hillbrow, it's a busy place. It's a place where, it's an area where you get all kinds of people. You know, it's from all walks of life. You get South Africans in Hillbrow, you get Nigerians, you get Zimbabweans, you get Cameroonians, you get all people here, you know, few Chinese and few white people are in Hillbrow.
It makes it exciting. It's a boiling pot of different people with different ideas, different cultures all together and living harmoniously, you know, which is most important.
Hillbrow, it's a place of dreams, what can I say? Aye, it's a nice place. Yes, rent, everything is cheaper. Well, I mean, lots of people who get along, a lot of things from all over the place. What you call a rainbow nation.
Well, Hillbrow is a dirty place, you know. It's not all over dirty, but there and there, not all over. People are working and doing stuff, selling kwasa kwasa food on the street, putting your stand. They were selling fruit and stuff.
Free,
Yeah, cheap. To get something. People are surviving, man, here. Chinese shops, Nigerian shops, Tanzanian shops. We are all in this together.
Yeah, to live in Hillbrow. It's a very nice place, you know. Every other place is like any other place. It's got its bad and good, you know. Hillbrow is a nice place. Sometimes it's too dangerous, you know. There's a lot of crimes because there's less job, too many people, you know, flats. If you can see in other flats in one room, maybe other people are seven, you know. They all came from all over the countries to come and hustle, you know.
There are too many foreigners, like Nigerian people, so many countries. Ethiopians are here, Zimbabweans, but I don't need Zimbabweans. Zimbabweans, they are our neighbors. But the Nigerians, I hate them. Because they're dealing with drugs, stuff.
Yeah. Most of the time is where you find drugs with them here and here, bro.
They deal with the guns and all those stuff. But I hate them, I think, yeah. Because I don't like those stuff. All I like just people to socialize, be cool, though. Socialize with each other in life, and that's it. Don't like Nigeria. I don't know, maybe my girls, they do love them, but me, I'm out.
Because everybody's just coming. Even if you don't have any papers, the passport are available. The border gate is open. Everybody can come in this country. And yeah, we don't know how they enter this country. And right now, the crime is high. Even South Africa, they cannot even control it. No, Hillbrow is worse. Can't change. The more they are coming, there is no way Hillbrow can change. It's the worst area you can come across in South Africa.
Hillbrow, it was dangerous, but now I don't think it's dangerous anymore. But there's a little bit of danger because there are people who are coming from, they are new here, so they still want to do those things they were used to do before.
So here in Hillbrow, the big secret, you must be simple. Yeah, it must be simple for everyone, talk nice.
Hillbrow is supposed to be careful. Yeah, to talk with people nicely. If you don't fight, be simple. Yeah.
Don't call on you, take off you. It's like when you see there's a lion, you don't go to the lion. Obviously, you're going to avoid it. You pass another way. That's the way you have to behave. I mean, if there's a problem, you know that street is not safe, then you use another street to go to a place. Yeah. Simple as that.
It's hell for this one. That's why I don't trust many people. And I don't go alone. When I go outside, I go with my friends. We go in groups because we are scared of being attacked. If you go alone, you'll get attacked. You understand?
You have a spirit of your brow. Yes, it has changed, but it's always been a positive spirit, you know? Even if you don't have a cent in your pocket, you can still feel excited about being here. Just the vibrancy, the color, the people, it makes me excited. I feel alive when I'm here. Even if I'm half dead, I feel alive, you know? And it's given me that, you know, there's hope. You know, everybody's got their little piece. You know, you can come and set up something, you can set up a store, you can make you a little bit of it's an honest living, you know?
Yeah, it's a rough neighborhood with different people from different places. It's a rough neighborhood. It's full of crime and everything is happening here.
Yeah, everybody knows everybody. You know, so you're totally safe here. You walk around, you greet each other in the streets. People have greeted you. You know, you walk around wherever and we all know each other. How's it? How are you?
That's what I love about Hillbrow, is that every day I feel a part of something greater than myself, you know, and that's beating. Slowly, slowly beating. It's all these people here for whatever reason, you know, and passing through, and it's just got such a wonderful, lovely energy, you know. There's creativity, there's everything, you know. So even if you have nothing, you don't have a rand in your pocket, you don't feel poor. And that to me is what makes it so special. It's got something rich about it.
Because we are significant here, different kinds of people coming from all over. because they told themselves that time they didn't see Johannesburg, it is a place to be.
Even though we're homeless here in Joburg, but we know that one day, okay, God is going to help us, you know, through what we are hustling. Others are studying even now, others are doing their own thing, but we're one family. We soldiers camp. Yeah.